And actually, this will be the last trend I'm going to quickly talk about. Communities will develop and take control. And, you know, this has been a conversation that's been happening for several years. We had companies back in the day, 2006, 2007, companies like Jive and Lithium, who were building these communities where kind of, I don't want to say they were forums, but they were kind of forums with more broad capabilities, right? It was kind of a community where people can converse and talk about technology and talk about, you know, the things that they're passionate about. If you go to Apple forums, you know, that is built on a Lithium platform, which is now Khoros, but it's a way to answer questions and solve, you know, customer challenges. And so, you know, I think brands have been talking about this for years because they've been investing money into Facebook, millions of dollars, you know, building communities on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and all these channels. And we don't really own, well, the brands don't own the experience. They don't own the community. And so if, God forbid, you know, one of these, you know, social networks went out of business, then, you know, these brands are going to lose everything. They lose their entire community. They lose that one-to-one engagement that they have with millions of fans. And so I'm starting to see a lot of brands who are building experiences that are on domain or on, well, maybe not on domain, but owned media. So they're building these experiences that require registration, that, you know, emails, newsletters is one kind of way to think about it, where they're building a channel to where they can have and build community directly with their audiences without having to go through these large social networks, because it's kind of unfair, right? If you think about the decline of organic reach, and, you know, back in the day, you had 100 fans, you posted on Facebook, you posted a piece of content and 100 people saw it. Today, you have 100 fans, you post content, 1 to 3 people will see it unless you pay for it. So I understand the trend. I don't know if it's going to like take off, but it is something that brands have been really, you know, talking about for several years and trying to, you know, figure out how do we build a place that is scalable, that is a place where, you know, our customers, our audiences will feel accepted, will feel like they have a voice, and also one that is going to deliver value. So again, I think it's a good thing to talk about. I'm not sure it's going to come to fruition, you know, full force in 2022, but it's definitely worthy of conversation. So